Hello, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Hi, my name is Ko Turk, and what I said, I'm going to tell you everything about the micrometer. I will tell you something about Micronaut and micrometer and Spring Boot. So let's go. Imagine the story. Imagine that you're part of a racing team. You are the one behind the monitoring. Like, hey, you are thinking of the strategy, and you are responsible for how the car is doing, for example, or you need to know how long a pit stop take and do they forecast any rain. It's all about car racing, and it's not only the driver, in our case, the developer, it's the whole team. Why are we making the mistake when we building our software? Why don't we implement metrics by default? We want to know our strategy, right? We want to have monitoring, proper monitoring, and we need that. So we need to think about proper monitoring. It's like, hey, you have a backend and an application, and application Y, but application Y is still running, but you don't see it. In the log, you see everything is still there, but your application is slow and that kind of things. Your health is not good. If that's happening, then that's not good, of course. You can log everything, but that's not all. Like SLF4J in a Maven dependency or Gradle. You can catch your exceptions and you can do a log.error, of course, if something breaks, but that's not always the case. Or you can you can debug it, but you're never going to read this except if you change to debug, for example, but then you need to ask your customer to try it again, and then you don't want it. So a log is an event that happened, and a metric is a measurement of the health of a system right away. And that's where micrometer comes in. Hi, my name is Ko Turk. I'm working for Blue4 IT, a small consultancy company in the Netherlands. I'm working for the Rabobank, but not anymore in the towers, but in my own shed. It's perfect, it's quiet. But I'm communicating with my team, of course. We have a great tech stack. I really love it. Spring Boot, TypeScript, Cloud Foundry, Micrometer, Angular. And I love that. Speaking about IDEs, yesterday I had a talk about IDEs, and today Micrometer. I like to drive the trial bike, and I'm mostly visiting the Utrecht Jerk before COVID. And the stack where we all about is going to talk is about Spring Boot, Micronaut, of course, with Micrometer, and with Prometheus as a database, and Grafana as a dashboard tool, if we have enough time, because we're going to a live demo, so you can see some live demo from me. But first, some theoretics. First, we're going to define the metrics, then create them in Micrometer, that's the live coding, and then save it to Prometheus and visualize it with Grafana. It's like what I said, it's in a car racing team, you need to know your strategy. Before you're going to production, you need to think about a strategy. You need to have some metrics. How are you going to maintain it? What do we want to monitor? You can think about, for example, maybe you have some old SOAP calls to old systems. Maybe you have a Kafka cluster. You have some REST endpoints, database calls, and you really need to think of that. Otherwise, you can have incidents and you have no idea what's happening. And that's not good, of course. A book that can help you, and it's free. It's from Google, Site Reliability Engineering. It's about how to be good in DevOps. It's free. You can search for it. And it's about searching for service level indicators, objectives, and agreement. And you can see it like, I want to have race factors, tactics, and a strategy. Some small things like, we want a pit stop. And how long does it need to take a pit stop? You can see it like a request latency. a service level object, you can see it. You want to, you have your pit stop less than 8 seconds. And like an SLA, you can see it like 2 pit stop less than X seconds. And that's all about it. So we have one SLA, and we're going to work that one out with some live coding. So let's prepare the car. Let's tune it to win race. Micrometer for the win, but what is it? It's a kind of logging, but only then for metrics. Why? It's easy, an offender login. And if you use Spring Boot, it's really even easier. All kind of support, Cloud Foundry, simple to use. It's very easy, I will show you. I'm going to tell you something about Maven also later on. I can show you something in Gradle, of course. But in Spring Boot, it's only dependency you need is the actuator. Include it in your Maven dependency and you're good to go. And in past Spring Boot 1.5, you also have a legacy plugin. You have it also for Micronaut, what I said. You only need 2 dependencies, the core and the management, and also something for your database, like StatsD. I don't know if it's a database, by the way, but Prometheus is. So you can also replace it with Prometheus, and then you use Prometheus, for example. You already got some pre-configured bindings like caches, class loaders, garbage collection, thread pools, and many more. And it looks like this. Sorry for the white. It's evening already. Sorry. You get a lot of for free already. And you can also create your own. That's perfect, right? So let's go. This is some demo time. But first, I want to know, because we have a half an hour left, what do you want to see? Like, do you want Micrometer or Micronaut? Or do you want to see Spring Boot even more? So please check this URL, go to menti.com and use this code. And just reply what you want to see. Oh, I need to, of course, show you the results. So please do. Then I will give a live demo of the one that win, and I can also later on show some more about the other one, of course. It's also no problem. Spring Boot. Okay, that's a perfect. It's even closer. Okay, 15 voted, 16. I think we have a win, I think. I will show you for now about Spring Boot, but also show you Micronaut. So please tune in also if you want to see Micronaut. We have it also there. But I will begin from Spring Boot. Micronaut. So thank you for voting. Oh, it's gone. Check. So you have all kinds of metrics you can use, like a long task timer. And a long task timer, you can see like, hey, if you're racing the whole race, you want to measure the whole race. That's a long task timer. It's a timer that lasts long. And I will show you more in a minute. But first, I created already a Spring Boot project. You can just do it with new and already done it. I think I already predefined some things like packages, and I have a test application. I excluded Spring Security because I don't want it now. Of course, if you run in production, you need to configure it, right? Otherwise, everyone can see your endpoints and you don't want it. So the first step, that's simple. We have we want a controller. So of course, want a race controller, like we are defining a controller. I don't want to ask it again, please. So what do we want? We have a REST controller. We have a request mapping, and it's listening to car.race. So we have our controller. So what do we have? You have even more. We have a request mapping. It's listening to this one. If I need to do this, I think like this. What do we have? Yeah, what you can do for micrometer, for you have an annotation, it's called timed. First I need to edit in my POM, of course, otherwise it will not work. So I have some dependencies. I have a dependency, I have an security. Oh, something else. I have a dependency, I'm going to add pom.xml. Oh, I can just do it like this. Of course, it's actuator, it's all there, already there. So all you need is actuator, so that's easy. It's already evening, sorry. So we already have it. So we have a value, and the value can be the name of the car, dot long task timer, and then you also have long task is true. And now we created an timed annotation, and that's the long task time. So if you do a public for of a public string race or something, just what you want. We also have a domain. A Formula One car, for example, Formula One car. And I also have it here. It's a live template, perfect. Controller, car controller. So we already have it. Oh, here's the controller. I don't want the controller, I want the domain. That's the dot car dot Formula One car. So we have it here. So we have a Formula One car with all kind of things. I will explain later. So we have a car now, and we can say, hey, I want a Formula One car. Formula One car. Formula One car. And we want a constructor, of course, with it. And here you are. So Formula One car dot driving. And what this is doing is just doing a thread.sleep. And it's wait some seconds and just to simulate that you're driving. So add an annotation and return. Let's race. So for now we created a controller. We also want an application.yaml. So application.yaml. Also want to have it security, of course. So I've also Prometheus. I will come to it later, but I already define it. So let's run it. Here, just play it, run it. Let's go. I already have a test here. Okay, just delete it. Not interested, thank you. So we now started our Spring Boot application. We started the controller. And now it's time to start local host, and we have a car race, but by default you get your metrics here as actuator / metrics, and here you have all your metrics, so you can already read those. Like if you want to have your buffer count or something, you just do this and you have your buffer count, and you can also read it later on. I will tell you everything about it, for example for Grafana. So we have now a metrics. So we already create one. So let's call that one localhost / car race. And now it's driving. And what you can see now is that there is a car long task driver timer. So we can do it like here, and we will see, hey, it's running, and the duration is this milliseconds. You can also change to seconds or minutes. Oh, it's now seconds. And it's one active task. Can also give some text with it. So we are now driving and we created our first one. And you will see also here the metrics. By the way, if you have some questions, I will answer them at the end. So please chat them later on. We will check them. So it's there. So you have a car long task timer. So you can, we create our first metric. Next one is what we want to see is the timer. You also have a timer. Like if you have a pit stop, you want to measure it. You want to measure the time, how many times you have had a pit stop. Like mostly it's 2 or 3 maybe. Exceptional is 4, but let's create a timer. And it's also, again, very easy. I will show you everything about Micronaut later on, by the way, so don't go. So again, we have a request mapping and we call it, request mapping is listening to / pit stop, cardway / pit stop. And again, we have a timed annotation. And like you thought, it's already there, car dot timer dot pit stop. And public string pit stop. And then you can do Formula One car dot your refueling, for example. And then you return done with pit stop. So we created our second metric, like the timed. So we're creating a pit stop timer. So again, I go to restart. You will see car of race, and we can do here pit stop. And ta-da, we have a pit stop. And again, we should see it here, car of time and pit stop. So you can see it here, and we have again a count and a total time. I was giving a time back of 3 seconds. It's very fast, and a max also because we have 1. So if you have the next one, you can see it's 2, and it's the total times even that's very quick pit stop, by the way. But we created our second timer. There are multiple ways to roam, we say in the Netherlands. So there are multiple ways. So you can also do it like this. You don't need to have an annotation. You can also create it here, like metrics.timer. You can give it a name, car timer dot pit stop dot pit stop 2. And then you can say, hey, record it. Like Formula One car dot refuel, and then you created another one. So there are multiple ways, but I said you can also do a bit more. Like you can also have a registry, like a Prometheus registry. I will come to that later on, or I can just, I will do it right away. Maybe it's handier. What you also can do is, if you want to use Prometheus, for example, you can add in your POM, you can add a Prometheus endpoint or a dependency, like here. So you have a dependency of POM. I was hoping security.
Sorry, Co?
Yeah, sure, no problem.
Could you increase the font size a little bit?
Yeah, sure. Fonts. Like this, is it okay?
Yeah. Great, thank you.
Thank you for mentioning.
Sure.
Just going. So, okay, dependency, we can add dependency. I will check the dependency of Prometheus. So, copy it and paste it here. So, you also have a Prometheus endpoint. You can start that one. And then you get the metrics of Prometheus. I will show you in a minute. We're creating a Prometheus registry. Prometheus registry. Oh, it's not there. So need to reload Maven. It's there. Sorry. Resolving. So you have a Prometheus registry, and we call it registry. And again, I'm lazy. I want to delete this one. And we are outwiring this one. So we have a registry. We can also use the timer. So registry.timer and then record. Then you will expose it to Prometheus. I will show you in a minute. There will be added one more endpoint. So Prometheus can read it, scrape from it. So again, check it. So what we did is we added Prometheus. We have now our Prometheus endpoint. So Prometheus, our database is reading this. So if you do a car.pitstop, again, it's a super quick pitstop even. And you will see here you have a car pit stop timer, and here of 5 seconds. A bit one. You can also do it like here again. Like if you want to read it, you can also do it like this. So it's the same, and we have 5 seconds this time. So we now expose it with Prometheus. I will show you also in a minute how you can read it in Prometheus later on. But first, I tell you everything about Micrometer. I will go to the next one. What I said, there are multiple ways. You can also define it like metrics. You don't need to use Prometheus. You can also delete this one and then use this. Or you can even use the timer.builder. It has some more functions, but yeah, I'm using Prometheus because I want to expose it to Prometheus and later on to Grafana, our dashboard. Next. That's my presentation. Yes, my presentation. You also have a counter. A counter can be like adding one lap. It's only incrementing. So you have it's only positive, and you also have a gauge. You can see it like the tire wear. So if your tires are not good anymore, you need to have a pit stop, right? So the tire wear can be positive or can be not negative, but it can be 1 or it can be 100 or vice versa. So let's create those metrics. Check. So again, we have a request mapping. We call it ads of laps. Do it like laps. Easy. And again, we have a public. We get giving a string back, and we add lap. And again, we are adding a lap. So what we can do is again the metrics dot counter. But we want to expose it this time to Prometheus. So we have a registry dot. What was it? A counter. And we can just car dot race dot add lap. And now we can also increment it. So we increment it by one lap. So every time we're calling this, we're adding a new lap. So return, we can do this. Right. Let's do it like this, just edit one lap. So we created our second or third metric with the counter. So again, we can start it again. We have pit stop and we can have lap. So we have now added one lap. And again, you will see metrics. You can see, hey, I have a car raced at lap. By the way, the other ones are deleted because I didn't save it because the application is stopped and start. So we have now a lap. So we have a count of one. And I expect a count of two now. So we're now in lap three. So this is just a count, it's simple. It can be very powerful. It's simple. Check. Okay, next one. What they say, you also have a gauge, like the tire wear. Slash tires. Tires good enough. And again, Lubbock string, I get tires, tire wear. And again, we can do a gisty.gauge, and we give it a name. We give it a name, car.race.tire wear or something. Number of life templates. So of course you will need to get the tire wear. So this Formula One car is just returning 50. It can also be returning 47 or whatever. It can be random. We now created our fourth metric. So it's very easy, it's really no problem. Oh, it's metrics, by the way, guess we need to add it. So and again, we are returning. We can give a Formula One car to get tire wear. It's just for an example, of course. So now we created a gauge. So we can change this one and we change it to tire wear. Tires, of course. So returning 47. And again, you can see it here. Gauge. We created a lot of metrics. You can start Prometheus. So let's start Prometheus. I just said Prometheus and Prometheus. More caps lock Prometheus. Oh, the CD bin, I think. Where is it? Prometheus. So start Prometheus now. And it's reading from my endpoint. You can check it localhost.1990. I will just continue because the time is already gone. I will show you in a minute. About security, you can also implement security, what I said. Otherwise you expose your endpoints, you have basic authentication, but you can better do it better. Don't forget it to add it in your database config. And the next step is save it to Prometheus, where to store the metrics, which database should I use. There are multiple databases you can use, but we use Prometheus. Is it persistent or not persistent? If you use, for example, Cloud Foundry, and you just push it there, then it can be gone if you restart the application, but better to have it separately and persistent. What I said, you have a dependency, and just change it if you're using another database to another one. And it's just easy, you just change it now to another database. You get this, what I said. But how to configure your application with Prometheus, what I said is where is it? It's gone, sorry for this. in application, you can just enable it like here, and you enabled it. So that's easy. So like localhost 90. So here we run our application. So what as you see, you have already some counts, like you can have a graph. Oh, it's not executed yet. So tires gets car tire wear. This one executed. So we already executed this one for 47. So perfect. So we have a database. You can see it also, but you need a tool like Grafana. Yeah, first graph of the Micronauts may be handier. I first show you Micronauts, and in Micronauts is it also easy. I will just share my screen because I already have it. In Micronauts you can do it like the same. Yeah, you have a race controller, of course I call it hello controller, and you have, yeah, it's working the same like in Micronauts. You only need to define your controller, your times, and it's exactly the same. And the meter registry, you can also have your Prometheus registry, what I said. So what I show you with Spring Boot, it's exactly, oh no, not exactly, of course, it's more or less the same. I was using Gradle, for example, in the Micronaut. It's perfect to use in Gradle. Yeah, you can use this dependency, of course, what we also did with Maven. You need the core and you need the management, and you're ready to go. And also don't forget to use this one, Micronaut bomb of 1W2 minimal, because there the at timed is you can use. So what I show you, it's exactly the same. You can create a counter, a tire wear. Yeah, it's there and you can use it, and it works really perfectly and it's easy to install. So I can recommend it to everyone. So next step is to, every time I have it, visualize it with Grafana. So like Mercedes, they have a pure pit wall. That's really cool because they can see how the car is doing, how the rest of the field is doing. And that's really perfect. We also want something like that for our monitoring. We want to see, hey, how is our application performing? And this is perfect. You can do it with, for example, Grafana. You can create nice dashboards. You have Datadog, Dynatrace, Instant Waveform, and many more. So I pick and choose Grafana because, yeah, I have experience with that. Deep dive into Grafana, I will show you in a minute. So again, I have here, I want to start the Grafana server. And the Grafana server was running 8081. Okay. It's important. So we have a Grafana and we want to create a dashboard. We want to see our pit stop, for example, or our gauge. So localhost 8081. And tada, I already logged in. So the first you need to do is you create your data source. It's Prometheus. I already did it, so I can go back because I already have it. Next thing is to create a new dashboard. So you can add a query. And again, because you're connected to a Prometheus database, you can just search for it like, hey, car, what do we have? I have a car, long touch time, what do we have? Oh, we created this one. So we can create this one, yeah. Let's do it. I don't like this kind of view, so let's change it. I don't want the left X. We want to show it. Yeah, you can show it. Like we want a series, so left eyes is handy, of course. 47 is the minimal, like here. So you can also change it to graph, for example. You can have a minimal of nil till 100% your tire, oh, 100. So your tire can be 100, it's perfect, or it can be zero, it's pretty bad. You need to have a pit stop. So now we create a graph, first graph, cool. And you can even make it better. Like, hey, we can make it say 47. Like 80 is red, but you don't want it, right? You want to have red if it's less than 50. Oh, it's even more. Can I change it, for example? You can have it green, like green there. The base is red. So, for example, yeah, I can even add one more, like 75.
Co, just a quick reminder. Yeah. You should come to an end of your presentation and switch to the Q&A part slowly.
Perfect, almost done.
All right, perfect.
So yeah, it's very easy just to create like this. So we created our first panel. You can also change, for example, your you can also get an alert, for example. You get a text message, or even that is possible, I think. So we created our first dashboard. So yeah, let's edit. Oh, we edit here. So we save it, save dashboard. And we save it. We are creating our first one. And you can also create another one, of course. Let's create one more, just because it can. So we can also have car. We first want a pit stop, of course. We do a pit stop. Ta-da, it's in the, there. And we want car pit stop timer count, for example. So we have, and again, we have several pit stops. So you can make it however you want it. You can make a Siri, like you have one. 140 is so we have the minimum of one and the max of the count. It's even more, but yeah, let's have it suppose for one. Yeah, you can just edit also here, and you have your save it, and again return to our dashboard, and again you have your pit stop. Yeah, of course you can change the name and that kind of things. I didn't change it. Like a pit stop count, but you can also use it for your own application, right? So we created several things, so you can even make it better. Of course, it's just an example. Again, it's gone. Okay, so what we did, you can create a long task timer. It's 8k seconds. It was a total race time. You can have a counter of pit stops, what is said. You have a max count of 5.5 seconds, for example. You have the tire wear, what I said. The bindings. So you have predefined bindings. We have 20 threads living. You can see it like cars. That's pretty cool. And you get a dashboard like this. And of course, it can be even better. So, yeah, let's enter it. We did a race, and I think if you choose micro or not, you'll really go win the race, I think. And thank you for listening. All examples you can find at my GitHub. I will add also later on the Micronaut, and the Spring Boot is already there. Please ping me or message me at Twitter, at CoTurk, follow me and I'll follow you back. Thank you for watching and listening. Do we have question one? I see. The first one, a Prometheus is optional when using the micrometer API instead of a GIS tree. Will it show up in Prometheus? What I said, you have different, I thought it was an interface like metrics. Your metrics is just exposing it to actuator. And if you use the Prometheus registry, it will expose only to Prometheus. It's optional, and you can also use, for example, Graphite if you want, and you can also make different registries if you want, because you want to expose it to, for example, Splunk or something. Yeah, it's possible. if I understood correctly, metrics created with, and yeah, I always want to expose it with all APIs. Oh, check. Okay. If I understood correctly, metrics created with annotations are saved to global registry, and all endpoints always prompt for global plus relevant specific registries, EA Prometheus. Do correct me if I'm wrong. I'm wondering about use cases where multiple non-global registers might be useful. Yeah, it can be handy, for example, if you have multiple monitorings, like I have what I said, I have a Grafana instance, for example. And I also have another instance with Splunk, for example, because I want to log my metrics. Yeah, I don't want to do it, but yeah. If you want to want to be quick and you don't have Grafana, you can use Splunk, of course. You can expose it whatever you want. Like if you have multiple monitor systems, you can do that. So mostly it's only one, but yeah, you can expose it to multiple. Maybe you also have a Datadog instance. Maybe you have another database. It's all possible. Thank you for listening. Back to you, moderator.